Hello everyone, today we are going to start from where we left in the last video. We were discussing about penicillin and the antibiotic that works on the mechanism of inhibition of cell wall synthesis. Today we will discuss about cephalosporins and vancomycins. This is antibiotics part 2. Let's start with suicide inhibitors first. Normally an enzyme is required to metabolize substrate into a compound. But sometimes this compound irreversibly inhibits this enzyme. So, the compound is planning its own suicide, like he wants to kill himself. This is the case in suicide inhibitors. Example, we were discussing penicillin in last video, so this is an example related to that group of the antibiotics. For the penicillinase, suicide inhibitor is sulbactam clovalic acid. The next one is, we are going to start with cephalosporins. Now, cephalosporins and penicillin have same mechanism of action and almost similar side effects. Cephalosporins have four generations, first, second, third, and fourth. First one examples are cephalexin and cefazolin. These are used against organisms such as E. coli, Klebsiella pneumonia. Now, how do you differentiate between these four generations? The first generation drugs and the second generation drugs do not enter central nervous system. You need to memorize this point. Whereas the third and the fourth generation cephalosporins can enter central nervous system. Now, the second generation drug is cefartetan. Third one is ceftriaxone, which is given intramuscular. Cefixime, which is given orally. And it is used against gram-positive and gram-negative bacteria both. Example is in case of gonorrhea. You give ceftriaxone intramuscular. The fourth generation drug is cefepime, which is given intravenously. Now, side effects are similar to that as of penicillins. That is, we'll see hypersensitivity reaction, we'll see rash on the body of the patient, and Coombe test will be positive. Let's jump up to vancomycin. Now, the mechanism of action here is a little bit different. It binds to DLRDLR, muramyl pentapeptide. After binding to this pentapeptide, it stops transglycosylation reaction. That is, it again inhibits cell wall synthesis. This is used against organisms such as MRSA, MRSA, and Enterococci, and Clostridium difficile. Now, what is the full form of MRSA? Methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. You need to memorize this point as well. Now, vancomycin is usually given intravenously, except for one case, which is colitis. In case of colitis, that is colon inflammation or colon infection, you'll give it in oral form. Now, this cannot enter central nervous system again. For the side effects, it's very interesting. You'll see a person with a red body. He'll look like a red apple. Red man syndrome because of histamine release. The body will secrete more histamine and the person will be red man, look like a red apple. Another side effect is nephrotoxicity. One more is ototoxicity. In case of nephrotoxicity, you'll see the person is having proteinuria, that is protein in the urines. Whereas in case of the ototoxicity, the person will have problem with the ear. For example, deafness and other signs and symptoms. That's all for the inhibition of cell wall synthesis. We'll discuss about inhibition of protein synthesis in the next video. Thank you.